Welcome to the Spy Collection. This is Anastasios and we'll have a look at one of the most prolific Soviet spy cameras from the Cold War era, the Ajax-12, or Ajax-12. This camera was built by KMZ. This stands for Krasnogorsky Mechanicheskiy Zavod, which in English it translates to the Mechanical Factory of Krasnogorsk. It was built between 1951 and 1995 explicitly for the KGB, and it is widely known by its factory number, which is F-21. This camera was designed for the KGB for covert photography and surveillance, and later it was adopted by most intelligence agencies of the Eastern Bloc. For this reason, you will come across this camera by numerous intelligence agencies during the Cold War. Nowadays, this camera is a very popular historic artifact in almost any spy museum around the world. Literally, almost any history book on KGB or Cold War espionage will have a reference to this camera. Even the Secret History of KGB Spy Cameras, which is considered one of the best, if not the best book for this topic, has it in its cover. Unlike other Soviet cameras like the KF-30 that I demonstrated before, this one was built for the KGB and for this reason it has no viewfinder. The operator was not supposed to look or aim through the camera. Those cameras were almost always concealed and the operator was taking photographs by just pointing the camera towards the target and taking the shot. It's a small camera made from a metal body and the only thing that we can see over here is the serial number. According to some sources, even that serial number was classified since the KGB was using those to track any lost cameras. Since it was designed to be concealed, the operator couldn't manually wind the film after each shot. For this reason, this camera operates with a mechanical winding system that you can see over here. So after we have winded the camera and we depress the shutter release button, it's going to automatically rotate to the next film slot. Here you have the counter for the shots and a button to reset it back to a different number. And here of course is the shutter speed that goes from B, which is for manual, to 1/10th of a second, 1/30th of a second, and 1/100th of a second. The lens of the camera can be tuned manually by turning that, and you can replace them by unscrewing them like that. You see that the lens also have some grooves. This is in order to attach different concealment devices that we're going to be looking at in future videos. You can see one of them over here. This fake button also has grooves and it is transparent so that it will allow the camera to see through it. This specific lens it's a 2.5, it is also written on the inside, and by manually rotating we can set it to 2.8, 4.5, 6.8 and 16, as you can see here. We just have to manually rotate it to make this happen. Let me put that back in. From the official manual of the camera, we can see that it was getting shipped along with some accessories. What you see in the photo over here is the film cartridge. This was coming in this box that you see over here. Those film cartridges could vary in size, allowing from 14 photos up to 100. Each box had two of them. Here is an empty one where we can roll in a new film, and here is one with a 21mm film. At the bottom side of the cartridge we see an inscription. We also see some pins. The inscription reads Zakrita, which means closed. We can find exactly the same inscription at the bottom of the camera. And you can see it over here. This is how the camera body is secured with a film. So let me open this up. That allows us to have a better look at the camera and how it operates. We place in the film to better demonstrate the operation. Let me put in an empty film. Now that the film is placed, if I press the shutter button, oh, I have to wind it first, you will see that the shutter will open and will expose the film that normally sits over here to whatever the lens sees. The small pins of the film cartridge are being secured by the indentations that are sitting on the other half of the body. You also see those small latches over here. This is what keeps the camera together, because those are being inserted to the spots that you see here. Although it is a camera which is very easy to operate and maintain, it had one disadvantage. It was using those 21mm films, while almost all of the Western countries at that point were using 31 or 35mm films. For this reason, the so-called special lab or special workshop of KMZ created this device. This special device allowed the intelligence officers to buy regular 31 or 35mm films from the local countries, place them on this side, over here, pass the film through the roller cutters, and cut it to 21 millimeters. Once they were done, they could use this cutter to cut the film and place it in their cartridges. Although the Ajax-12 camera is relatively popular, those cutters are very rare, since they were provided only to spies that they were needing them for their operations. I didn't want to make this video overly long, so I'll be showing some of the concealment devices and accessories of this camera in separate videos. But until then, remember that in espionage, nothing is as it seems.